Are equations of any use in real life? Yes. Let's see how. Imagine you work in a fruit distribution center as an operative, and your job is to allocate crates of apples and grapes to the representatives of different supermarket chains. Today, you have to prepare an order for a representative who's just arrived at reception. He's asked for 130 crates of grapes. But do you have sufficient in stock to supply him? According to your current records, there are 300 crates in the warehouse today, weighing a total of 13,800 kilograms. But, unfortunately, you can't access the data that shows how many of these are crates of grapes and how many are of apples. All you know is that a crate of grapes weighs 40 kilograms and a crate of apples weighs 50 kilograms. Let's write the number of crates of grapes you have as being x. They weigh 40 times x kilograms. The number of crates of apples you have in stock is 300 minus x, which weighs 50 times 300 minus x kilograms. The total number of kilograms is 13,800 equals 50 times 300 minus x plus 40 times x. This equation can give us the number of crates of grapes that we need to know. 13,800 equals 15,000 minus 50x plus 40x. Therefore, 10x equals 1200. So, x equals 120. Our equation has shown that there are only 120 crates of grapes in the warehouse, which means we cannot entirely meet the needs of this order. Equations can help us to solve other types of practical problems as well. Let's see how the owner of a hotel solved a tricky problem with his swimming pool. Some students staying at a hotel are due to take part in a swimming contest in their activity schedule, but the pool has been drained for maintenance, so he needs to refill it. The pool is filled by three taps. The owner knows that the first tap alone can fill the pool in 24 minutes. The second tap alone can fill the pool in 20 minutes, but he doesn't know how much it would take for the third tap alone to fill the pool. He knows that the three taps together can fill the pool in just 8 minutes. He decides that he'll fill the pool 30 minutes before the contest starts. When he opens the taps, he realizes that the first two are broken and only the third one is working. Here's the dilemma. There are only 30 minutes left before the contest starts and only the third tap is working. Will the contest be able to start on time? The third tap is now running, but to reduce the stress created by the situation, the owner wants to find out as quickly as possible if the pool will fill within the 30 minutes he has left. So if the first tap alone could fill the whole pool in 24 minutes, in just 1 minute it would have filled 1 over 24 of the pool. If the second tap alone could fill the pool in 20 minutes, then in 1 minute it would have filled 1 over 20 of the pool. If the third tap alone can fill the pool in x minutes, then in 1 minute it would fill 1 over x of the pool. If all three taps are working simultaneously, then in 1 minute we would have 1 over 8 of the pool filled. Remember, the three taps working together can fill the pool in 8 minutes. Using what we know, we can express the situation with this equation. 1 over 24 plus 1 over 20 plus 1 over x equals 1 over 8. And when we solve the equation, we get our answer. 1 over x equals 1 over 8 minus 1 over 24 minus 1 over 20. 1 over x equals 1 over 30, which means x equals 30. 30 minutes. Our handy equation has given us the time in which the third tap alone can fill the pool. The contest can start on time. The owner breathed a sigh of relief, knowing he wouldn't have any disappointed guests to apologize to today. Look out for our next video with more maths that can help you handle real problems. If you like this tutorial, share it with your friends and teachers.